All right, now let's take a look at some sports, and here's Charles Eruka.
This is The Ultimate Redefined.
Recognized as Sports Person of the Year, so it really, really meant a lot to me. And being a woman and being, you know, only the third to be recognized is pretty awesome. Determination and dedication. You have to be so dedicated to do what you want to do every day. So, and you have to be determined to not let anyone stop you.
It's game, set, and match for Super Serena on Sports News, and it's back to Ijoma with the rest of the news at 10.
This is The Ultimate Redefined for Men.
Several huge protests were held across South Africa today, with protesters calling for the resignation of President Jacob Zuma. Temi Tokwefagwemi tells us more.
It seems the people of South Africa have lost confidence in President Jacob Zuma after he appointed three finance ministers within 1 week. Protesters blame the president for the country's economic woes. Meanwhile, the protests have gone beyond marching on the streets to the social media. A number of hashtags have come up, especially the one hashtag Zuma must fall.
Recently, he sacked a very good finance minister, causing turmoil in the markets, causing the rand to devalue. But he's also a president who's been associated with many scandals. And the people of this country have decided that the time has come to stop just whispering that we don't want this president.
However, the ruling African National Congress has rejected the protest and calls for President Zuma to step down. In the Middle East, at least 27 Qatari hunters, including members of the ruling family, have been kidnapped in a desert area of Iraq near the Saudi border. Iraqi officials said the attackers were driving about 50 four-wheel drive vehicles when they swept into the hunters' camp at dawn. Police say a wide-scale search has been launched for the attackers. Finally, U.S. Republican presidential candidates have held another fiery TV debate, the first since the terror attacks in California and Paris. The candidates clashed over national security issues and how best to counter the Islamic State. Frontrunner Donald Trump was on the defensive, with Jeb Bush calling him a chaos candidate. And that's the Foreign News wrap-up. It's back to you, Joma.
Thanks a lot, Timmy Tokwe. And the main news again. The extraordinary summit of the Economic Community of West African States is holding in Abuja. President Muhammadu Buhari told the gathering on the 48th anniversary of the regional body that democracy has come to stay in Africa. Well, the president is to lay the 2016 budget before the National Assembly on Tuesday, December the 22nd. Lawmakers have decided to shelve their Christmas vacation to Tuesday next week. And thousands of protesters have marched in South Africa to demand President Jacob Zuma's sack. Well, that's the news at 10 tonight. Thanks a lot for staying with us. I'm Ijoma Bunyato. Do have a good night.